And our next presenter is our own expert here in EDU, Dr. Prathibha Mahanama Eva. He's going to share with you some thoughts on re-examination of existing laws relating to posting offensive content on Facebook or Twitter. So Dr. Mahanama Eva, time is yours. Thank you.
Chairman Dr. Karunaratne, other experts, and my colleagues. Today I am going to discuss the most burning issue in the world and Sri Lanka. That is where everyone connected to Facebook. In this audience, tell me anyone not connected to Facebook or Twitter? All are connected. So that means it's a burning issue. But do you know the legal content as well as what are the laws related to Facebook and Twitter? This is the area of cyber law. Cyber law consists with many parts. Intellectual property rights, e-commerce, data protection. Those areas are very, very important. But Facebook is a global network. We are people connected to each other. We have seen in Sri Lanka also, Facebook, there were certain deaths. We can't blame Facebook one side, but there are certain connections with this. My specific area of research, where I was interested, Sri Lanka police spokesman, he gave a media conference last month. There are 5,000 Facebook violation cases. 5,000. That means lot of offensive materials were posted as well as defamatory materials. So we must see from where we are going to find a solution. Because Sri Lanka, we have 2007 Computer Crime Act, which does not address this area. Social network, whatever happening, not connected. So therefore, I will discuss with you now what are the laws available in India, in United Kingdom, USA, with several case studies, how we are going to find a solution. My first question for the audience, my first issue, is it right to jail someone of being offensive on Facebook or Twitter? Sri Lanka, there is a case. Near the election period, the present president's fake Facebook drafted by someone. And thereafter, in that Facebook, there was a content. Mepara Mage Chandin Mahinda Rajapaksha. Who is saying that? Maithripala Sirisena's honorable president, Facebook. And they were looking from where this has been posted. Finally, they found a Sri Lankan person from Kuwait. While he was coming to Sri Lanka, he was arrested. Now the issue to the Attorney General, whether he can be arrested preparing this type of material and because of the online network Facebook. Luckily, they had a legal position because election period. So in the election period, you can't prepare those type of materials. So it went under penal code. So not on Facebook offensive material. Now that case is pending in front of Chief Magistrate Colombo. So that is one case. And I'll come to some other cases also. Now, this is the latest one. This way, Jake Newsom was jailed last month for posting offensive comments online about murdered school teacher. He made certain bad comments. And also, any person has the right to make a speech, to give your comment, to discuss several things. Is there any limitation? That is the biggest issue. Now, he was arrested because he posted some offensive comments. West Yorkshire police arrested him, charged Newsom under 2003 Communications Act, not under Computer Crime Act, not under Computer Misuse Act. So this is the only law they have. But Sri Lanka, we don't have this type of Communication Act. So how we are going to arrest him? The issue is this: you are sharing, you like that, and share with some other friends. So this was shared by more than 2,000 times. Basically, this act says, by means of public electronic communications network, a message or other matter that is grossly offensive of an indecent, obscene or menacing nature. In that case, you can. Now the issue, he also having a right, freedom of expression. European Human Rights Court basically went against, they criticized this judgment also. And there was another case, familiar pattern, that is where in October 2012, Matthew Woods, 19, was jailed for 3 months for posting sexually explicit comments about the abducted child in April that month. So several cases are there in United Kingdom where offensive material, but it has been not defined, the parameters of offensive material. And where you see the limitation, that interpretation is very important. And another case, 2012, Asa Ahmed was prosecuted for post made 2 days after 6 British soldiers were killed in Afghanistan. But he said, all soldiers should die and go to hell. So it was shared everywhere in the world. Now this was via racist Twitter sent after the incident. And this was criticized by, once again, European Human Rights Commissioner Thomas Hamblin. Because he has a right to free speech. Now, where you draw the mark? Whether we put it under criminal matter or whether a civil matter. If it is a civil matter, it takes several years. So immediately you can't stop it. That's why we have to find some solution. And former director of prosecution, they also said, new guidelines prepared. In Sri Lanka, we don't have social media guidelines. Now, in United Kingdom, after this case, they prepared certain guidelines after a big debate. So now I am opening the debate for Sri Lanka, for the Facebook. Lot of participants are there. You can use the privacy tools, but we also must have certain type of guidelines. That's why police media spokesman specifically mentioned, every month we are getting 500 complaints, misuse of Facebook, offensive materials. But sir, there is no legal stance in Sri Lanka under which we are going to sue. So he believes these guidelines are good job in difficult circumstances. So even you don't have a law, you can come up with a policy. In India, Apex Court, Supreme Court, there was another case where Karnataka chief minister was highly offensively criticized. Thereafter he was arrested. Then he challenged in the Supreme Court on what? Posting objectionable comments on social networking sites. But Supreme Court also said, you can't arrest him. But in India, the Computer Crime Act also included in the 2008 Information Technology Act. Luckily, they have a section. Section 66A, the Information Technology Act 2008, included a provision for 3-year jail term, anyone posting offensive materials. So he was arrested. But in the Supreme Court, they said, this is a constitutional right, freedom of speech, which really confront with this section. Therefore, the Supreme Court judge basically came up with the provision, you must file the case under Penal Code of India. I mean, Sri Lanka Penal Code, we can't file. there is no criminal defamation, which was abolished in 2002. So now how we are going to see a solution for Sri Lanka? So 66A, India provides punishment for sending grossly offensive messages. Though communication services including text messages, images and video. So the act is very vast. When Sri Lanka was preparing 2007 Computer Crime Act, we never thought this type of, some type sentence. We have section 3 to section 12, all these offenses, but not this type of. So the judges, they really very interested with this, but the issue was, still they have a constitutional right which cannot supersede this act. So in the hearing, it was very interesting, just follow that case. They have a right, to discuss everything in Facebook, but offensive materials, there is no chance for them. And also a law student, this is where again Shivasena, he posted certain materials again, that because I have a freedom. I can reasonably criticize Shivasena. And this guy was also arrested under section 66A, religious. There are certain limitations under that. But still, freedom fighters, or even those who are working for free speech, they say it is basically free speech campaigner. He really started a campaign, Facebook, you can basically communicate anything. But anything means not all. That's why USA decision is there. In USA, there is a Supreme Court decision. Very recently this was delivered. This where online threats aren't crime unless you really meant it. This is a very recent Supreme Court case whose Facebook basically he used certain abuse language in that. Now this is the sentence. This is the comment he has given. Thank you. There is one way to love you, but 1,000 ways to kill you. Like that, you just read it. Whether it's an offensive one or not. Based on that only, he was arrested. But even Supreme Court judges, three judges were really gave the judgment for freedom of speech, but other two judges, they went on another side. So in future, we can see several cases are coming. In Sri Lanka, we have two cases at the moment, teledrama and film actresses. They got money from Velesudha or someone. Five beautiful film actresses. But they said they haven't seen whether Velesudha black or white. Right? But anyway, it has been offensive materials. But the issue, director CID said, you can't pursue with this because we don't have a stance. You go for a civil defamation case. But the film actress say, no, we don't want to waste money like that. We need something. That is where Sri Lanka must look and think, it can happen to you, it can happen to me. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Mahanam Hewa, for your very exciting presentation.